from the enemy. You're a superhero. You're a superhero.
Hello guys and welcome back to another stream. Today is the grand finals of the TOF Dream Team Tournament. We have Team Pointers playing against Eternity. Our broadcaster today is Loyalty and commentating with me today is Defeat. Hello Defeat.
Hello Greg and welcome everyone to the live stream. Obviously the grand finals for TOF Dream Team, so it's going to be a very interesting match. Hopefully I feel both teams are very well they've played this format a lot in the past, so they're definitely aware of how tactical this match could be, and I'm guessing it's going to go all 10 rounds. Do you have any predictions, Greg?
I'm not sure. There's people on both teams I would like to see win, but I think Team Pointers are gonna take this match.
Yeah, honestly, my prediction is Team Pointers in 8 rounds. But let's see, maybe Eternity can surprise us. They've played very well to get here to the grand finals, obviously, because I was looking at the bracket and they did go to the losers bracket in the playoffs pretty early, and they've made it all the way back to facing Team Pointers again in the grand finals. I believe Team Pointers haven't lost. They've come from the upper bracket all the way to the grand finals, so yeah, we expect them to play really dominating.
Yep.
So the players have self. For Team Pointers, the starters are Yarek, Immortal, Hero Dao, Lin Amal, King of TP, Mr. Vanko.
For Eternity, we have Marikos, Avetis, Magellan, Dropkiller, Semgun, and Riggs.
Yeah. Avetis on the Hornet. He's using Magnum, Lin Amal starting on the Hornet with his Railgun.
Dropkiller disarms Mr. Anker's bomb. Oh, what a nice overdrive by King of TP, but Riggs uses his overdrive.
Yeah, I think this is looking good. He just needs to take out Mr. Vanka. Lin Amal coming from behind him. He does have his overdrive. I think he'll use it. No, he doesn't.
Nice dictator overdrive by Marikos, giving Riggs full supplies again. The Immortal and King of TP are coming from the right side. Avetis is trying to block them.
Yeah, King of TP should drop the flag for Immortal, but I think this is looking like a first capture.
Wow. Really fast then, capture from Eternity. Yeah.
Less than a minute, and they were... Yeah, exactly. Now, if they just need to continue being aggressive, I think they can't... even if they get a lead early, they need to continue playing the way they have. So... Mm-hmm. We'll see Semgun pulling right through the middle, and he's got support from Avetis right there as well. But he's getting surrounded by 4 Team Pointers first. Oh. I believe Marikos is going to play Dictator, and he's going to be the main def.
Marikos has been playing Dictator for pretty much the entire tournament, really. Sometimes he's using... Most of the time, I think he's been using Smokey. But as we're talking, Riggs is pulling another flag. I'm not quite sure how he did that, but he just drove into the base and drove out, and it's another flag in less than 2 minutes.
Yeah, this is a very good start from Eternity. I mean, people probably weren't expecting a slow start from Team Pointers, but here we are, 2 flags in less than a couple minutes.
Yeah. Mr. Renka trying to pick up the flag now. He uses his Wasp Bomb, but only takes out Semgun. I haven't seen Team Pointers attacking together very much at the moment. They've just sort of been coming in one at a time, trying to take the flag, but it's not been working so far.
Yeah, I agree. King of TP actually pulling through the middle. I think he gets taken out. So, yeah, you're right. I think it'll be interesting how Team Pointers come back from here. I mean, there's plenty of time, and Red Alert is a very small map, so.
Yeah, I personally think Team Points are actually better in larger maps.
Yeah.
I mean, they are also very good in Sandbox. I think Red Alert is very, very, very compact as a map.
Mm-hmm. That's true. And I believe we're going to be playing Sandbox as well at some point today. We're going to be playing... It's going to be 10 rounds, and we're going to switch maps after 2 rounds each. Mm-hmm. So, there's going to be 5 total maps.
And King of TP is actually playing the Fagnol, being chased by Marikos. King of TP does have his overdrive. I don't think he needs it.
Wow.
Yep, Lenormand
using it. Really good stuff. He's going to get the capture easily. Yeah, and you're right. Lenormand's overdrive was basically the difference maker there.
Yeah.
This is, I think Eternity need to continue the aggressive play that we saw from them in the first couple of minutes. Let's see if that continues.
Marikos actually changed to Smokey now. He was using Railgun with the fast shooting alteration, but I think he's changed to the Smokey Freeze ult now.
Yeah, I think that's the smart play. The Smokey Dictator, in my opinion, should stay Smokey. It's just probably he was using the Railgun to throw off the protections from the other team.
Possibly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and Mortal Hero down are coming in for attack using his overdrive.
Yeah, takes out Marikos.
Under X, but Chop Killers.
King of TP's overdrive was just a second late because Chop Killers gets the return right in time. And now, yeah, this is not as favorable for Team Pointers, but maybe it can still be a pull.
Oh, Rix has his overdrive. As well played by Marikos, he drove back and gave Rix his overdrive. Semgan coming, Avetis coming in for attack now. Uses his Magna overdrive. And Lenyama, wow. Nice easy capture for Avetis there.
Because of his overdrive, he's able to do so much damage, and he just took out the entire team, basically.
Mm-hmm.
A 3-1 lead is looking really, it's looking really good for them right now.
Mr. Vanker just seems to be pushing on his own with Waspman fire at the moment. Oh, he uses his bomb to take out Marikos. Can he pull this flag, actually? He's got King of TP there to help him. He's going to go through the middle. Could be a solo cap. Oh, but Semgan takes him out. King of TP grabs the flag.
I think this is good. Top killers have Rix, the only players there, but they're not even able to contest. So King of TP with the capture. So 3-2. I mean, they're down a flag still, but anything can happen from here. Wow.
Wow.
What a nice overdrive from Dropkillers. Because this looks like a solo easy cap for Rix here now.
Yeah, Rix has pulled some nice flags this game so far.
Yeah. 4-2 is a pretty strong lead, in my opinion, because there's only 3.5 minutes left. And I'm guessing Team Pointers are going to be pushing really hard right now in the last few minutes.
Yeah, I think in the last few minutes is really, really, you need to save your overdrive for the most perfect moment. Otherwise, you're gonna make mistakes and not be able to come back from them.
Yeah. I don't know if you realized, but Marikos used his overdrive and immediately left. And then he came back and he switched his turret, his protections, I believe.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, smart play from him, but. They need to hold on to their death in the last couple minutes because I believe Team Pointers are going to push with four people. Lenormand with his overdrive camping on the right side.
He's just trying to respawn everyone with his railgun while Mr. Vanker takes the flag. Can he take out Marikos in time? He does. Oh, nice shot by Avetis.
Wow.
Really good shot by Avetis. Oh, nice overdrive by King of TP. Gets two people with that.
Mortals?
Pulled on the left side. Semgan's 1 HP. Yarik takes him out. King of TP grabs the flag.
He has Lenormand backing him, though. But Dropkillers...
He had his overdrive as well. All they need to do is take out Rix and they can capture this flag. Marikos is coming as well. Can he get the flag? Just gets that flag. Wow.
That was so intense. A great capture from Team Pointers. They're back in this game. 2 minutes left and they're only down a flag.
Yeah, I mean, we saw Eternity capture two flags in 2 minutes. So it's possible. to capture one to tie this round for team pointers.
Yeah,
and Yamal does have his overdrive, which could be key. I think Yarik is going to use his overdrive now.
Okay, everyone's got overdrives now for team pointers. Not everyone, but Mr. Vanka and King of TP.
Oh, nice overdrive by Avetis, taking out Len Yamal. But I think his overdrive should almost be charged because he was overdrived by Yarik. But they've got 1 minute to try and come back from this 1-0 lead. Rix has his overdrive. I think he's going to play a bit more defensively now.
Yeah, I think Eternity are going to use their overdrives in defense.
Oh, Chopkillers is coming in for an attack. He's got
Immortal, though. I think this is good.
Chopkillers is pulling as well. Nice overdrive, King of TP. Can he take out Rix?
Somehow, Immortal flipped, but Avetis picks up the flag. Wow, this is looking really good for Eternity.
It's just Len Yamal there. He has overdrive, can he? Oh. 5-3.
I'm pretty sure not a lot of people thought Eternity were gonna come up the game in the first round, but that's very well played by them.
Yeah. So yeah, at the end of that round, the score is 5-3 to Eternity.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, we're going to show... No, we're not going to show winners because we didn't even do the form yet. So we're going to open the form now. And guys, go ahead and enter your nicknames. The link of the description to the Google form is in the description. What am I saying? Sorry, I'm distracted. But our broadcaster just pointed out that Kusu wasn't playing the first round. And he's right. So maybe we're going to see him. There's no way he's just going to skip the grand finals. So
maybe he I mean it could be because they need rounds for some players. I don't know whether Chopkillers has been playing main through the tournament, but maybe he needs a few rounds, so maybe they're letting him play.
Yeah. But Chopkillers is playing for Eternity. And Kusu's playing for team point.
Oh, yeah, my bad. But to be fair, Chopkillers is actually playing really well. I don't know whether he's main for Eternity.
True. I have no clue. But I guess there's going to be a 5-minute tech pause. Looks like, yeah.
Oh.
So we can pick winners after we close the form in a couple of minutes.
Yeah. If you guys got any questions, feel free to ask them in the stream chat.
Okay, so guys, we're going to go for a 5-minute pause too. Please stay with us and listen to some music until then. We're on mute, right?
Hi guys, we are back. So it looks like, after all, the technical pause was to give Kusu a chance to join, because he's joined now with Magnum Hornets.
Yeah. I forgot who was playing Magnum for them last round.
Well, it was Lenyamal playing Rogan. Yeah, Rogan.
Yeah, right. So he does get subbed out. Lenyamal's not playing. Everyone else stays, and Kusu's joined for team pointers. And I believe this is going to be interesting, because as everyone knows, he's been the MVP in this tournament and setups too. So we'll see how he plays this round.
Well, Avetus takes out Yarik. Maybe he can pull the flag. He's got King of TP to deal with still. He runs into Kusu.
Wow.
Wow. What is going on?
I think there was lag and people using overdrive at the same time, but both teams pulling right now. Rix should be able to get away, but King of TP uses, wow, what a critical overdrive.
Lenyamal's going to pick up this flag now, drops a bomb for Yarik. Gets chased by Mr. Anka.
King of TP, this is looking good. Kusu is going to pick this up, but he's not. He uses his repair. Rix right there. Wow, what a nice drop off. Immortals in trouble, sort of. Avetis is going to be first. He's going to pick up this flag, and they're going to get the return, I believe. Because Avetis is. Well, never mind. Team Pointers with the first capture. I thought that was not going to be a return, but great job by Team Pointers there.
They got some good respawns, to be honest.
Yeah, true.
The base looks pretty clear for Semgrand and Avetis.
Yeah,
Semgrand goes the right way, but runs into a mortal. He's taking a lot of damage.
Semgrand
manages to get out.
Doesn't have a repair, but I think he doesn't need it because he's got Avetis right behind him.
Yeah.
Oh, they jump down. Kusu is pulling on the other side.
King TP and Immortal both have their overdrives.
Wow, this is going to be a return. King of TP gets the return and Immortal's pulling. This is actually looking pretty promising for our Team Pointers.
Soranka going back to defense to block Avetis.
Yeah, I don't know.
When he misses a shot on the flag, I think he could have killed him as well.
No. I don't know if it's Kusu, if it's the red side in Red Alert, but Team Pointers have done what Eternity did.
I think it's a bit of both, because I think Magnum is a lot better in this map.
Yeah.
And maybe Lenyamal wasn't comfortable on Magnum, but this red side, I think, is definitely better.
So Hyarik is going to...
Wow, look at Avetis' drive through the base. Unchallenged. Easy capture. Easy solo capture for him. That was close.
Yeah, that was close. I thought Kusu, because his overdrive also just unlocked right at that second, but 2-1 lead for Team Pointers right now.
Kusu's going to go up the flag now. He's got his overdrive. He takes out Avetis. Semgrand can't escape from Immortal, and that looks like a third capture for Team P.
Three-one lead for now, but anything can happen. 5 minutes still left. So there's plenty of time. Immortal pulling through the canals right now, and I think this is going to be a capture unless Rix and Avetis can get there in time.
I think Team P finally just got into the swing of things.
Yeah.
Maybe they're a bit rusty first game, but now they're ready to win, I think.
4-1 is looking really good, and they've basically dominated this round.
Anchor, Mr. Anchor, taking the scenic route back to the base.
I mean, he's got nowhere to go now, but still.
I mean, it's good because if Eternity pull, they need to go out all the way up there to go and return the flag.
Yeah.
Which they managed to do, and Riggs is pulling. I don't think King of TP has his overdrive there.
So it'll be interesting from them. Sam Grand, I don't think he's going to be. He uses his bomb, which he probably didn't need to.
Yeah, I mean, I think the boss bomb is only good in certain situations when someone's literally stuck and they've got the flag. You should take out everyone in the air. But I think most of the time it's kind of probably one of the weakest overdrives. In this format, at least.
Yeah, you really need... I mean, if there's a Mammoth on the other team, then maybe it could be useful because Mammoth's too slow.
Some gun flips and couldn't get the return. But Chop Killers should be able to.
Yeah, unless Immortal... No.
No.
Vrix uses his overdrive. Maybe he didn't, but he's pulling through the middle and he's gotten back in his base. So this is going to be a third capture for Eternity. I think they're still in this game. And Avati is pulling with his overdrive too. Can Briggs get it? Wow, he picks up this flag, but Immortal takes him out immediately. The one flag lead, anything can still happen.
Yeah, I mean, there's still 3 minutes left. There's lots of time. It's just really about who saves their overdrives for the right moments. Mr. Van Kren, King of TP, might be able to pull this flag, actually. Rick's doing a good job. Mr. Van Kren drops his bomb on Marikos, but doesn't take him out. He's still going strong with the flag, runs into Immortal. Albert Semgan's put a very nice bomb there. Well played by Simgun, actually. That was one of his highlights, I think. That's a good question.
Yeah, we have no clue. But King of TP does use a good overdrive. It'll be interesting if Team Pointers play more defensive, but they shouldn't. King of TP is going to continue this pull from Kusu. He's going towards the canals, but Simgun takes him out. Well, yeah, we'll see. It's going to be interesting if Eternity have it in them to continue the comeback they have. They were down 4-1 at the start of this round. Now they've managed to come back within one flag. Let's see if they can cap a couple more flags here. Avati's doing so much damage with his overdrive, which he runs out of. Pretty bad timing, but Drop Killers is going to get this pull started at least.
Mr. Vanker's on respawn. Can he get take care of him?
Sam Grand is going to drop his bomb. But that's too late. Minutes still left, but they don't have that many overdrives on Eternity, right?
Yeah, but I think Mr. Vanker and... I can't remember who else. Who else used the overdrive just now? Oh, Immortal. Both just used their overdrive. Oh, Kusu flips.
That's unfortunate. He had a clear shot from the canals to actually make that a pull, but doesn't matter. 50 seconds left. Team Pointers need to hold on to the lead.
Yeah, they'll be in a lot of trouble if Eternity come back from this.
Drop Killers gets stunned by King of TP's overdrive.
Riggs has a chance here. He's got his overdrive. Or which he uses, takes out the two defenders.
Wow. Avicii's going to and help him. On the other side, Immortal's going to pull, but we'll see. Avicii uses his overdrive. He just needs to play careful now. hit all his shots. Wow, this is looking good for Eternity.
Immortal's trying to escape, but he's been blocked by Semgun and Chop Killers. Can Mr. Ranker do anything?
Eternity with that comeback right there.
Yeah, in the last few seconds. Wow.
No. You would have thought that it's over, but surprise. So that Eternity.
I mean, it's not over. I mean, a tie is better than a loss.
Yeah. Yeah, Eternity was almost 4-1 down the mid round. I think there was 4 minutes left, and they came back to get the 3 flags. So that's very well done for them.
Yep.
Yeah, we're going to open the phone. If you didn't win the first round, the first cycle, then go ahead and enter your nicknames again, and we're going to pick the winners after round 3.
So what map are we going to next, Pete?
That's a good question. I have the list, but I'll have to pull it up. Give me 1 second. So it is going to be Sandbox for the runs 3 and 4. And then we're going to go to Forest, Bob Risk, and then Bridges to end it.
I haven't seen Bridges played much this tournament.
Yeah, and that's going to be the rounds 9 and 10 if we need them. So, which I really think we would, because this probably is going to go all 10 rounds, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen a lot of Sandbox, a lot of Forest, quite a bit of Bob Risk, actually. Not so much Red Alert, but a few times. But I don't think I've commentated any Bridges, actually. As far as I can remember.
That's just because Ian's stream has been inactive, maybe. Okay, so we're going to be starting Sandbox matchmaking pretty soon. It's a small map, so it's going to be... It's actually the smallest. It's even smaller than Red Alert, so...
Yeah, it's small, but it's still quite hard to pull the flag because the spawns are literally right next to it.
The reason why it's important for the Magnum players to do well here is because there's so much dependency on them because it's such an open map, so.
Exactly, yeah. I think we saw Pap join as well for Team Pointers. I don't know whether he's going to be playing this one.
I don't think they're going to change the team too much because that's what I've seen from them. They hardly change the players at all. So most likely we're going to see the same 5 now that Kusu's available. And if they need to change, they're probably going to put in Lenema. But, yeah, it'll be interesting. Okay, so can you show the map again, broadcaster? Alright, so we're going to be starting round number 3 momentarily, as both teams have reset it already.
Mm-hmm.
The Dictator always switches to Isida. Is that because they like by healing they're trying to get the old
Rat faster? That's the reason. I mean, it's clever, but I don't know. Maybe for the next tournament it shouldn't be allowed. Because basically everyone just comes off from spawn with the overdrive.
why wasn't the grand finals on a Saturday or Sunday? Because there's hardly, that's just the scheduling, I guess. I don't have a good answer on why it wasn't. Okay, so yes. Round number three.
Don't go for it.
Yeah, but I believe Pap might be playing.
Yeah, he's been known to do very well with Thunder in this tournament.
Yeah, so I thought we're not going to change much, but who did the switch up?
Immortal?
Yeah, I think Immortal. You're right.
Yeah, Immortal.
They've kept the same team for eternity. For all three rounds so far, Drop Killers has been playing pretty well, honestly. So there's no need for them to change. And to remind everyone, Eternity are winning 1-0 right now in terms of round scores.
Oh, wow. Nice return by Marikos. I didn't think he would get that, actually. Look how Vettis is like hitting his magnum shots just perfectly over the sandbox in the middle.
Yeah, both teams actually pulling some grand all the way back into his base. Riggs gets the return. That's the first
really
cap.
Nice overdrive by Riggs.
If he didn't use his overdrive right there, I don't think they would have gotten that return. So.
Yeah, he's actually pulling again, but I'm not sure whether he's going to get away with this time. There's three Team Pointers players merging onto him. Can Yarick take him out? No, he can't. Everyone from Team Pointers is on respawn. Wow. And Aversus has his Hornet Overdrive.
Yeah, that's already two captures from Eternity. This is not good from Team Pointers. Are already losing in terms of rounds, and they haven't gotten off to a good start here.
Yeah, I mean, it would be surprising to see Eternity win, because obviously they went to the loser's bracket, and they even struggled against teams there, so it's surprising for them to then meet Team Pointers and then destroy them 3-0 in Sandbox.
Yeah, I know. Mr. Manka, I think this is going to be a pull because
Burbex is there with his overdrive.
Clutch player, he's used his overdrive twice now, and in both situations, if he didn't, there would probably been a return. Wouldn't have been a return.
Rix with another overdrive, wow.
Yeah, he just picked up that OD box and uses it immediately, and he's come all the way back into his base, so.
Nice overdrive by King of TP, but he gets taken out. Mr. Anker grabbed the flag.
Rix is in trouble.
Getting blocked by Avetis. Marikos is there as well.
Trouble.
Ooh, Pap just missed the flag. Oh, he was so close to getting the flag. He was pushed up against Drop Killers and couldn't turn to the side.
Kusu should probably camp from that position that he's in right now. Drop Killers has a overdrive, but he's going to get blocked.
Sam Gun looks like he's in a bit of trouble.
Rix has picked up the flag, but he's definitely getting surrounded. Finally, Team Pointers with the first flag.
Nice bomb by Mr. Michael. What an overdrive by Chop Killer.
Oh, Avathis probably is going to get a free capture right here. Uncontested.
Wow. I think because all of Team Pointers are dying at the same time and just leaving the base totally empty.
Yeah. Marcus is defending solo, but Semgrand pulling on the right side. So
5-1 to them right now. Marikos has been playing in the middle this whole time with Dictator, just trying to grab those overdrive boxes. I think Yarik isn't. I think maybe that's why Eternity are doing so well.
Yep, King of TP continues to pull. He uses overdrive on drop killers.
If Mr. Ranker can catch up to Avetis, he could return this flag. Oh, but how did Mr. Ranker flip there? I need to watch that back later. How did he flip?
Yeah.
Oh, I just looked at the clip. He just sort of lagged over him and clipped the tank on its side. But Semgrand's going to get that return.
Yeah, Semgrand gets the return. Rix with the capture. I think team pointers have sort of given up, to be honest. Even though there is still less than 5 minutes left, but it doesn't look like they're going to be trying hard to come back into this game.
They would have to capture like a flag in a minute, but I don't think there's enough time now.
Yeah.
Five flags.
I mean, they can just go on defense because they're that big of a lead at this point.
Pap with his overdrive. Picks up the flag.
Probably he's going to get a capture if he can drive and get through them. Yeah, he's going to get the capture.
See, look, Pap just self-destruct as soon as Semgrand was coming into attack. So it's an easy capture for Eternity.
Yep, Tropical is actually pulling. He doesn't even go back to his base and it's smart, so... Let's see. I don't think team pointers are playing a lot more aggressively now. You can tell, but
I bet it just got overdrive and missed Mr. Monk from point blank with Magnum.
I didn't see that. But he hasn't been taken out yet, but he is now. Tropkiller's coming in and breaks with his overdrive.
Great mind by Yari.
Honestly, this round's probably going to be a win for Eternity. 3 minutes left, 6-2. And Avathy's pushing Yarik too right now.
Yarik might need replacing pretty soon. He's on cooldown. But Kusu's going to get the return.
Maybe there's a chance.
Pap is actually pulling again.
Yeah, maybe there's a chance. I might have spoken too soon.
Yeah, I think we did, because Kusu can...
Never mind.
I've hit his Mr. Flag!
Wow.
What a grab by Mr. Wanker. But I think he's going to... Oh, he had the health kit as well. If Pap and Kusu can get this return... Bob Rix is there now. Oh, that was so close to being a capture.
I've at least missed the flag, but still they've managed to pull the flag out of their base, so... 2 minutes left now. Kusu with this overdrive gets taken out, so this is not looking good for Team Pointer's comeback.
Yeah, if they lose this round, they'll be 2-0 down after 3 rounds, so that's really not a good place to be in. But you never know, there's many rounds left. Oh, I bet it looks like he could be able to get the return here. Yeah, Rix on cooldown, and Rix has his overdrive. It's going to be a return for Eternity. Anything Pap can do? He can maybe grab the flag? No. 7th capture for Eternity, wow. After the 7, do you think Eternity are going to win, or do you think Team Points are still going to win?
I actually don't know. This is like a lot different than a lot of people were expecting. Eternity showing that they're ready for the grand finals, and they're going to be up 3-0. So, I mean, not 3-0, 2-0. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see what happens from here. But I honestly think the comeback from Team Pointers will happen. It's just when it's going to happen.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we saw them capture some flags back-to-back just now, but I just need to get back into the swing of things.
Yeah. Anyway, we're going to pick winners for the second cycle after this round. And then we're going to open the form again. So. We'll be broadcasting. Can you let us know once they're on the screens? A lot of people in the chat, 66 people watching, a lot of people in the chat rooting for Eternity. So I guess they want new winners, I guess. But the three winners on the screens are I Play For Win, Benefactor, and Extra Toss 15 The Killer. So congrats, guys. Are we opening the form right now? Again, I think we should. So we're going to open the Google form again. The link's in the description. This is the third cycle, so go ahead and enter your nicknames. Yeah, shout out to Benefactor for winning. Shout out to Slay, my bro. Welcome. So yeah, it'll be interesting. I think now they need to start putting some rounds together. Should Team Pointers, because don't want to dig themselves into too big of a hole where they're trying to play catch up. I mean, they're only down two rounds, but. And there is still seven rounds left in the grand finals, but right now, like especially the last round, Red Alert, both rounds were pretty close, but third round was just dominating from Eternity.
I think it's really a lot about the start in Sandbox. If you have the right start and you capture the first few flags, you should be like on for the win, because I think if you use your overdrive at the right time at the start and you capture the first few flags, you sort of have. I just think, obviously, your overdrive will recharge quicker if you drop the flags at the dictator. And then he can then give you more overdrives as a team. I don't know how it works, but I think that's maybe why. Because we saw Eternity capture a lot of flags at the start very quickly. And that sort of set them up for the rest of the round. And I think also Eternity had Marikos playing like in the middle of the map most of the time, taking that overdrive box. I did see him time it in the chat as well, so I think that's maybe what Yarik should be trying to do. King of TP gets the return. I don't quite know how, when there were like several Eternity players there. Avetis still pulling the flag though. Mr. Vanko driving on top of him. Can he get the return?
Such a good capture from Avetis. I mean, honestly, it's bad gameplay for Mr. Vanka, sort of. He should have, like, tried more to either pick up the flag, pick up the enemy flags, or just block. But either way, Eternity with the first lead yet again in Sandbox.
Michael's actually changed to Rogan now. Which is interesting. I guess it doesn't mean he can control the whole map.
Yeah,
a bit better with Rogan.
Usu with his overdrive, he's gonna take Marek out and probably. Oh, Avetis has his overdrive too.
Nice shot by Kusu though. Predicted where Avetis was gonna be.
King of TP has his
Nice overdrive by King of TP. And Mr. Frank is actually pulling again. Canavetti's... Oh.
Yarick goes for the OD box instead of Semgren, and yeah, I think Strupkillers just have his overdrive.
And oh, he gets Mr. Wanker with it.
Wow.
Nykos gets the capture. Oh, if Mr. Wanker could have got his tank around that container, he wouldn't have been hit by the overdrive. That was so close. Vez's got taken out quite quickly after using his Hornet overdrive, but Kuz is actually pulling now. And Rix is there, but only has DP. Pap comes to flag. Nice kill by Miracles. Can Mr. Vanko escape? Ooh, there's a mine there. I think he heard me. Oh, he didn't hear me about those mines.
Yeah, so plenty of time, but Eternity playing much better in sandbox. They're actually up again, and now Kusu versus Semgren. Semgren's so low in HP, but he doesn't die, and Tropicalis says, oh, Pap coming from... Oh, Pap's overdrive runs out, so now should be fine. Can Avithis return? He's got the overdrive.
He returns. Oh, he's... He killed himself with the Magnum, but...
Yeah.
Is our first standoff this game? This round?
I believe so, honestly.
I think it's our first proper standoff.
Yeah.
Nice shot by Kusu with that Magnum. Trying to get some shots on Rix. He makes him use his repair kit, at least. Wow. Avestis has got the freest return ever, but Pap pulling with Thunder Viking and his overdrive. He's one shot. Maybe Yarick's going to overdrive him, which he does. Kusu can maybe one shot the flag. He takes out Rix as well. Bit of an early bomb by Simgan and Kusu with the return. Avestis steps on the mine and gets taken out. All they need to do is take out Chopkillers and Yarick can capture this flag. Oh, but Rix is coming now with his overdrive. And Avestis kills Rix, allowing Yarick to capture. Wow. That was an interesting decision. But nevertheless, Semgren is pulling.
Yeah, Semgren's definitely going to get the capture here. So 3-2. They've taking the lead back immediately. 5 minutes left, so anything can happen here, but Semgren, like, you can tell that Team Pointers are trying harder than last round, for sure.
Definitely, yeah. King of TP pulling now. Half HP, I don't think he's got a repair kit. Nice job by Pap. The railgun. I think Railgun does work really well in sandbox.
Yeah, I agree.
Marco also somehow flipped with Dictator.
With this Dictator.
I don't know how he's managed that.
Pap
is actually playing again.
And he has the overdrive, so I think this should be a capture for Team Pointers.
Because he just grabs that from underneath some guns.
Maybe not, because Avithis has his overdrive too, and Tropicalers. Wow.
What an overdrive by Pap, saving the flag.
I thought Tropicalers was going to get the return 100%, but...
I thought he was going to get the return as well. Oh, maybe Rix. Oh, Mr. Vanker didn't block Rix well enough.
That was not good gameplay from him, but Kusu's pulling through the middle. Oh, yeah, frozen. No. Oh, they didn't capture. Semgren dropped the flag. And Eternity haven't capped. So it's still 3-3. Wow, man.
Rix is now pulling. He's going to make it 4-3 for Eternity. No one there to contest. Wow. And Vet is pulling again.
Oh,
They just captured two flags in about 30 seconds.
Yeah, literally.
I think I've said it before, but team pointers keep dying all at the same time.
Yeah.
And then they're all on respawn and turn to just pull flags like it's nothing. But King of TP is going to pull as well at the moment.
Yeah, this is definitely a cap for him. And he has overdrive, but...
Well, if Kuzu can take some people out. Oh, Semgan was on 1 HP. That was unlucky. I think if Semgan had died, Kuzu could have killed Avetus.
Oh, that's... Did he really need that overdrive right there, King of TP? I mean, honestly, that's not...
No. I think maybe he was banking on the fact that Yarik had his overdrive. So he was going to use it and get a new one from Yarik.
Maybe. Some grand pulling. Oh, Kuzu flips him with his magnum. But this looks like a capture irrespective. Wow. Eternity turned on the heat. And now they're up two flags, but 2 minutes left, so we'll see if that they can hold on. Wow, this is really good. Semgran with the easy free capture. Rick's using his overdrive, respawning everyone.
Yep.
Okay, I don't know.
Go on, Kyle.
I was just going to say, I don't know if it's the map, but team pointers are not looking good right now. And this is the grand finals.
I always thought team pointers played really good on Sunbox. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, round 4 is 95.55% going to Eternity now.
One minute left. 7-4. Two Eternity. King of TP is pulling, but Semigun's dropped a bomb. Can he escape? He does just about, but he needs a bit of help. Kuzu spawn there. Avetus is just running away from Yarik. He gets frozen.
Yeah, Marik's going to pick up that flag. Rick's in trouble, but... I don't think Mr. Wank is going to return. So, either way, 40 seconds left. Eternity have done it. And they're going to win both rounds in Sandbox.
Mm-hmm.
So, maybe we can have a shorter stream. Eternity just dominate. Team pointers, maybe. But I honestly don't think it's going to happen. I don't know. It's just a feeling. Every time team pointers are in this situation, they've managed to come back. So I can't rule them out until it's over.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so really good job by Eternity winning both rounds very comfortably in Sandbox. Now we're gonna pick the winners for the third cycle.
I'll let you do that if you want to think.
Yeah, once they're up, Okay, so the three winners on your screens now are BRBR Tanker 24, Tamaris, and Moi Gold 2014. Congrats, guys. How many can we do? How many forms? It's the grand finals. Maybe we should stop. But because we just did the third one. Another, I guess we can do 6. Yeah. Smile, do we need to open the form? Okay, we're gonna open it again, guys. So, we're gonna The Google form is now open. Go ahead and enter your nicknames in the description in the Google form if you didn't win already. I mean, if you won, you can enter it, but we're just gonna not select you. Rounds 5 and 6 are going to be played in forests, so yeah, it'll be interesting. I mean, this map is, yeah, it's the biggest map, I believe. Maybe Bobrisk is bigger. Is forest bigger than bridges and Bobrisk?
Yeah.
So,
wait, is forest bigger than Bobrisk?
I don't know. Really? Okay,
so it looks quite small, but it's actually quite.
Somebody said, Riyadh said, the same people are winning every stream. There's probably a glitch. I think you should talk to the broadcaster. He's the one picking the winners. But honestly, it's just randomized. It's just luck. We're not rigging it, guys. Chill. And you won yesterday, so I think you're digging for too many containers. Promo. Yeah. 67 people watching. Welcome, everyone. We are streaming the grand finals. We are in round number 5. Eternity have dominated. So far, we've played 4 rounds. One win a tie, 3 wins for Eternity. Everyone's expecting a comeback from Team Pointers, but maybe the comeback will come, maybe it won't. We'll see. I believe so. I think there's a new map.
Yeah, I think they're making a new map.
Who posted that link?
Right.
Someone saying I started playing back in like 2014. But I went inactive for a long time. So many things have changed since then. I mean, obviously. Yeah. Welcome, HTML5. Can someone translate what LBJ just said in the chat? Anyone that knows Russian?
I mean, I probably can't, but I can have a look.
Yeah.
Captain. Oh, I didn't see it in chat. I've only just joined, so I didn't see it. Right, I think they reset now. You're ready to start? I mean, I really don't know who I want to win, so because there's people on Team Pointers who I want to win, I said, and some people that I don't. So,
yeah.
I would really like to see Mr. Ranko win Acid. But at the same time, I wouldn't want to see Yak win Acid again. Mainly I don't know. I think Kusu's okay. Probably not Kusu, though. I don't know. It's a hard one.
Yeah.
mean, and there's also Acids on Eternity as well. It's just nice to see like different people win it, but it's always going to be the same teams, though, isn't it?
Especially if you put like a tournament where upgrades are on, you know, that just rules out. I mean, honestly, if they were off, too, it'd probably be these two teams in the grand finals.
Hmm.
But with the upgrades on, especially.
I think most people should, like, I don't think it's hard to get modules to 50% really nowadays, especially with matchmaking, the amount of, like, double funds and like all the boosted crystals events we've had, like, and all the sales as well, like the discount weekends and everything. There's loads of opportunities to upgrade your garage for these tournaments. I think it's easier than ever to upgrade stuff in your garage. Like before, it used to be impossible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can the broadcaster show the map? Some people are anxious. They're asking in the chat.
What? So the battle is now starting. This is the fifth round, if I'm correct. Is that right?
Yes.
Fifth round? Yep. Fifth round, and it's 3-4? 4-0?
No, 3-0.
3.
There was a tie. The second round was a tie.
Oh, yeah. Wow, Avetis has already flipped.
Shockulus just uses overdrive by himself, like literally no one. Anyway, he gets the return, that's what was needed, so it's fine. Okay, so we're seeing the same teams that we saw in the first three rounds. So Immortal comes back, Pap sits. Honestly, I think that's the right move. That when Pap joined, they lost both the rounds in Sandbox. So.
I mean, Team Pointers, if they want to win this tournament, they need to win these next two rounds because otherwise they are in very serious trouble.
Do you know if Sand Forest is their main map, sort of?
I don't know. I've seen them playing Forest. And I think they've been doing okay in Forest.
Yeah. I mean, they were doing
but at the same time, Eternity know how to play Forest as well.
True.
As you can see, Rix is going to return this flag, I think, with Avetis.
Yeah, as you said.
Marikos is pulling through the middle with Dictator.
Kusu is not going for the return, he goes for the flag and he's pulling on the right side now. Sengren's the only one who's going to be able to cut him off. Rix is out of supplies though.
Kusu having a bit of trouble dealing with Sengren, but he's managed to get past him. Nice overdrive by Chopkillers. Can he get the return? I think he can.
I think he can too. He uses his repair.
Yeah, I think that was so close.
I would have been clutch if he got it. But there's going to be so much standoff. I mean, this map is known for standoff, so I'm expecting there to be standoffs in this round.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if both of these rounds in Forest are actually tied.
Oh, Kusu is probably going to be able to, you know, he has his overdrive, but he's not rushing it. He's playing it safe.
Oh, nice shot onto Marikos. Both Kusu and King of TP with their overdrives. They should be able to take out Sengren. Oh, Kusu misses. Ranka's there. Nice shot by Kusu. Wait, how did Mr. Ranka die? Oh, it was killed by Versus.
Oh. Whoa, they even returned an Eternity with the lead now. I didn't realize that they returned, but that's a really good job by Dropkillers. I actually don't know who it was who returned, but that was well done. And Avetis back in his base with another flag, but I think Kusu's going to take him out.
Yeah.
So, Eternity again with the lead early in the round.
I think once they capture these first two flags, they're going to be pretty good.
Yeah, true. it's a big, it's not a big map, but it's a bigger map than Sandbox and Red Alert.
I'm still confused about how Mr. Banker died.
Yeah, honestly, yeah, no clue.
Because he, like, jumped off. I'm trying to find it on his own stream, but I can't see it. Anyway, back to the game.
Yeah, Sam Grand pulling. Yarik's going to pick up this flag, but he's in trouble. Tropkillers and Marek might be able to return. Wow. Nice return right there by Vrix. Does it can't go? There's no way. Why is he going?
Immortals is going to be able to grab the flag now. Can he get out with it? I don't think Avetus is overdrive. They should be able to. Vrix is going to get pushed by Immortal and King of TP. Chopkiller is going to come back in and give him a hand.
Vrix is in trouble. But yeah, he's got support now. 5 minutes left. And only a one flag lead for Eternity so far. I don't know what's going on. Team Pointers are not playing the way everyone probably expected them to play. I'm not seeing the throwing, but they're just not playing what is expected of them. Yeah, 2-0 lead for Eternity. This is looking really good for them.
I mean, if Eternity, I need to work out. If they win these two rounds,
it's over.
Then that would be the it's over. What happens if they win this one and then tie the next one?
You have to play.
They keep playing. Until... But still, that's not a good territory for Team Pointers to be in. Oh, Kusa might be able to get a capture. He's got his overdrive now. And so does Immortal. What an overdrive by Tropkillers. Mr. Banker gets the flag and Simgan returns. Wow.
Oh my god.
That's a highlight right there.
I hope a spectator saw that because that's definitely a highlight.
Wow. There's only 3.5 minutes left. Team Pointers really need to start attacking together.
Capture now, they're still in the 2-0 deficit, so that's not good. Tropkillers is a clear path. He's got no one to contest, but King of TP is also put on the other side.
I'd be really interested to see who's actually playing on HMO and who's not. Avetus with the overdrive.
Wow.
Gets the return. He takes out Yarik. Can Mr. Anka do anything with his boss bomb? He's going to need to take out Marikos and run. Oh, he flips. He gave time for Kusa and King of TP. Can he overdrive? Nice, well played.
That's what Tropkillers did to them. So there's still hope, but they need this capture from Immortal now, the Team Pointers. Well, Kusa needs to take out, get the return, but not looking likely. Tropkillers has his overdrive.
Immortal's trying to run away.
Actually, can Kusu return? No, it gets taken. Okay, 2 minutes left. They need two flags.
Yeah, Eric just uses overdrive for Kusu and King of TP. That's why I'm getting confused as to why Team Points are actually losing so much, because they're using their overdrives really well.
Kusu needs to use his overdrive and just dominate, spawn kill everyone right now.
King of TP with the Hunter overdrive. Can he get anything on Simgan? He gets the overdrive. And returns. Nice. First capture for Team Pointers. 1 minute 20 left.
That's Manker enough time, honestly.
Flipped. Again.
Avitis and Kusu both have overdrives on their magnums. Kusu not able to one-shot some grand.
Marikos just used his Dictator overdrive for Rix and Avitis.
I don't know. There's not enough time, I think.
50 seconds, anything's possible. Especially with a fast wasp.
Let's see if Immortal can start this pull.
Kusu's got his overdrive. He's going to use it now. Last chance for Team Pointers. Kusu takes out Marikos. Can Drop Killers overdrive him?
Nice job. Good.
If Yarik can hold the base, could be a capture. 20 seconds. Yarik needs to get this return. Oh, Avetis has his overdrive back. And he's just going to go on defense now.
What an
overdrive as well. Really well played. No time there.
I don't think King of Deep can return. No.
No chance there. Oh.
That's unfortunate.
That sucks.
So the comeback everyone's been waiting for, I don't think it's going to come today.
not today.
I mean, it can technically happen, but dude, it's just asking so much. Yeah, let's pick winners for round
I'll let you do the winners again, Duffy. Okay. It could be the final time. Do the winners for Toph Dream Team.
Yeah, let's see. The three winners on your screens now: Duality, shout out to you; Arjun 24, NRG, Mr. Savage. Congrats, guys!
Yeah.
So we're gonna open the Google form again, and it's gonna be in the description as usual. Please go ahead and enter any comments. Maybe this is the last time for Toph Dream Team that we're opening the Google form. So. All the best. Yeah, honestly, I'm pretty sure not many people expected this to happen, what we're witnessing.
I thought like 100% that we would have seen all 10 rounds and maybe even penalties. I didn't think Eternity would do this.
If anything, people probably thought Team Pointers would be the ones doing it.
I don't know how Eternity went to the loser's bracket in the first place, to be honest.
Who did do?
Because if they had played like they played today for their previous match. Yeah, I know.
Who's Control?
But to be fair, yeah, they did lose Control, but Control gave Team Pointers a hard time when like they were about to win, but they took over in the last few seconds. Maybe that's what they did to Eternity. They did some like last minute attacks. Because we almost finished the stream because Team Pointers were winning, and then all of a sudden Control just pulled the flag out of nowhere. And it was like, oh, more rounds. But yeah, back onto this match.
Yeah, I see.
Pulling the flag now. Kuta's on his overdrive. Yeah, Eric looks pretty good in defense. Maybe he can use his overdrive or not. Oh, but Jokulis has his overdrive. Immortal. Nah. Well played.
I think this is the first time ever Team Pointers have pulled and like.
And capped. Yeah, and capped the first flag. Yeah.
So maybe this is the change of fortunes that Team Pointers fans were hoping for. We'll find out.
I mean, normally, if they didn't have to wait for Kusu, they probably wouldn't have used the technical pause, and they could use it, like, now.
Yeah, true.
They can maybe win this round and then take a technical pause or something. Bit of server like that. Some guy putting the flag now. So is Immortal, but I think Marcos is going to be able to take him out, maybe. Avetis is there with his overdrive. Doesn't see the flag.
Mr. Venka spawns, and I think he's going to be able to...
I think this is going to be a capture for Eternity. Oh, Marcos just couldn't get that flag. And Avetis misses this shot.
That was so close, but somehow Team Pointers managed to hold off for a little bit.
Yeah.
Yarik's probably in trouble. Avetis and Bricks on him, and Bricks probably going to be able to get the return. Wow, so let's see. Some grand escaped so far, but Fusu's going to take the flag and get it out of the base. King of TP gets the return. Fusu's pulling. Actually, whoa, that's not good communication. Yarik and Fusu. Because he dropped the flag and he even used his overdrive, so it's not good. He's not even taking any shots.
Yeah, Kusu holding the flag now. He's got no double armor. Ricks picks up the flag. Yeah, Ricks going to grab the flag now. Avetis there doesn't have an overdrive.
Yeah, Yarik so far is safe, but I'm sure Eternity, because they're down a flag, they're probably going to play a little more aggressive. We'll see.
Oh, Mr. Lanka hits a mine and flips. Oh, that's a shame. I want to watch that on the stream.
I didn't see that. But...
Oh, he drove off the edge of like a ramp, hit a mine and flipped.
Oh, uses his overdrive and he's taken out. Oh, I thought he's going to take Kusu out too. But Tropkillis with his overdrive, I think he's going to use it. Yeah.
Gets the return. Mr. Anchor pulling again. He's got to try and save this flag. Marikos is there, though. Oh, King of TP uses his overdrive just on Marikos. That was interesting. But I think Sim can maybe get the return. He does. It's one all.
Yeah, Team Pointers, I don't know, they got the first flag, but after that, sort of fizzled out.
I think so, yeah, a bit sever.
Simran pulling. He's got Avetis.
He's on zero HP. Can Avetis get there in time? Yeah. But Yarix though, anyway. Oh, he flipped.
Kusu and Immortal might be able to pull this, to be honest.
Yeah, although Avetis does have his overdrive, he takes out Yarik, but he's frozen. Kusu's forced to go back because of Sebagrand. Immortal should take the flag, he's got his overdrive. Nice clear route for him, I think. Although Ricks is coming in, he's got his overdrive. I think Ricks is going to get some kills here.
Wow.
Nice, Ricks machine.
Wow.
Well played by Ricks. Well done, man. My true partner.
If he didn't, he would have been so... Like, if he didn't use it at the right time.
Yeah.
Good job.
Oh, look at Chopkillers stopping King of TP. Wow. And Kusu do anything?
Eternity back in the lead.
And Tropkillis is going again with the flag. What is happening? Can Mr. Anchor be sneaky? Oh, it hits a mine. King of TP's got his overdrive. Simgun's trying to get away from Immortal. Taking an interesting route around the base.
Yeah, I know.
There's no one there to help him. Kusu should be able to capture this.
So they are going to tie it.
Unless Rix can do something again. Needs max damage on his shot, but doesn't get it. Two-all. It's probably one of the closest rounds we've had, I think.
Well, let's see. I think we're going to see one more good pull from...
I think we'll see a couple more. We've got 3.5 minutes left.
Yeah, I think Team Pointers were in the pressure, sort of. They're the ones that need to attack.
Yeah. Yeah.
3 minutes left. 2-2. King of TP and Tropica is both pulling, and King of TP drops to Immortal, so. But Tropkillers has pulled, so this is going to be a standoff.
Sam Gunn trying to hide with the flag. Mr. Vanker's got his bomb. Can he do anything? He can kill him, but I don't think he's going to return. No. Has Marek seen Kusu? I think he has. Yeah, he has now.
Avatis. Wow, gets the return. And Marek's probably in a very good spot. This is...
Oh, no, it's 3-2 Eternity.
And now...
Still two minutes.
But if they don't die, at least, this game is over, right?
Yeah.
So they desperately need a capture now. 2 minutes left.
I mean, coming back from 4-0 down is so difficult. If they're a lot weaker of a clan and they're beating you 4-0, then yeah, it's possible, but... If it's Eternity beating you 4-0 and you're 4-0 down, you're not gonna come back. Avertis pulling again now. Sam going there to stop Mr. Anker. Can Kusu get away with this flag? Nice shot by Marikos. Picks around the house.
Sam Grand is not in trouble. I think Yarik's gonna get taken out, but Immortal's gonna pull on the other side.
Yep. 1 minute, 20 seconds. King of TP's quit his overdrive.
Rix
but Chopkiller's used his first.
Wow.
What a bomb by Mr. Anker. He can get some kills here. Rix with the return. Kusu with the return as well.
Okay, so there's still a minute left for Team Pointers to do something. They've got overdrives, so... Oh, White's King of... Oh, he's rushing because he can use it.
Yeah, it gave Kusu his Hornet Overdrive. This is their chance now to pull the lost flag.
Why is Kusu jumping now? He could have just stayed up. But...
Nice job by Kusu. Being chased by Rix.
Yeah, this is good. They just need to hold on their left side.
27 seconds. Can they do it? I think they can. Well played. Well played, Team Pointers. Well
played. There's actually enough time for one more, but there's no one.
Well played.
Okay, this grand final's not over yet, but this is going to be interesting. 3-3, so really well done by Team Pointers, at least to manage.
But I think now if Eternity tie or win a round, then it's game over, right?
And all they need is a tie, and then it's GG.
Yikes.
And, you know, to come back from that sort of a position is But yeah, let's be honest. Imagine you're, like, down 4 rounds, and, you know, if you lose one, you're basically... losing asset.
So the next map is Bobrusk.
Congrats to the three winners on your screens now. earn Tanker 4-3-2-1 and shut up. So, I don't even know if that's an allowed nickname, but congrats to you guys. Yeah, Benefactor, you already won, so shout out to you. Riyadh is asking to choose another one because they're saying that it's the same person. That's why we pick one more. They're all saying that it's the same person, but Ismail just said, let's pick one more. Yeah, go pick one more. Just cancel, shut up, delete him, and then pick one more. So the new winner is Scream. Is it? I can't see it still. Yeah, it is now. Riptail Master is the new winner. We actually don't know if they're trolling or not, but we just went for it. So shut up if you're watching. I'm sorry. I mean, we don't have proof, but yeah. I know.
Do we have a link yet? I think the battle's been made. I don't know where the link's been posted.
Yeah, I just posted it. So four flags, I mean, four rounds, and team pointers need to win every single one of them just to go to tiebreaker.
Mm-hmm.
And if they tie any of these four rounds, the match is over right there. And honestly, blue base in team, I mean, it's not, it doesn't matter that much, but Barbarous blue base is in that favorable. So, and they're going to start in the blue base in this first round, I mean, sixth round. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting. She's the yep. seventh round.
So what do you think is going to happen? Do you think Team Points are going to win like a string of rounds now and then maybe choke on the last one? What do you think is going to happen? Or do you think they're going to lose this one?
I honestly think they're going to tie this and it's going to be
over. Really?
But what do you think?
I don't know. I think Team Points are actually really good in this map.
So I think
this is one of their strongest maps because they play it a lot.
Okay. So you're thinking it's definitely going to go to Bridges?
No, I don't think it's going to be. I think Team Points are going to win this first one, this first round in Bubbles, and then they're going to like tie or lose the second one.
Yeah.
Because they've got... are they red side? If they're red side, they've got good side.
They're playing blue.
Yeah, they're...
Oh, actually, they might be playing red.
Yeah, no, Team Points are on red side, so theoretically they have the better side.
True. Yeah, so you might be right. It might happen in the next round. Because this round, they probably will win. But, you know, just having that sort of a pressure that you even tie one round, you're gonna be out. You're gonna lose. So let's see if that gets to them. So people are saying that we're biased because we re-rolled and we chose another person. I actually don't have an explanation. I think the nickname itself is also questionable. So, and the admin, this it's not up to me, guys. So the admin said it. So we had to do it. All right, we're gonna get into round now. Round number
wow.
seven.
Yeah, I don't know if you saw that, but Chop Killers just overdrives Kusu when he had his horn overdriving. Rix is gonna pull the flag.
Wow. Donna D with the first capture in 40 seconds.
Yeah.
This is not good for Team Pointers. They're trying to come back into this game and they need
Sam Gunn can pull again. Oh no, he flipped. Oh, he has such a good chance as well. Oh, yeah, it just shoves him into the hole. Chop Killers now. Oh, he tries to use his overdrive, but got taken out before he could. Kusu might be able to pull the flag here. Oh, but Rix uses his overdrive.
King of TP is probably going to be able to pull this, but they need to hold on to their base right now. Why not?
Yeah, so it's going like to be a capture for Team Pointers.
Yeah. So at least they've managed to tie it immediately, sort of.
Mm-hmm. That's good. It's always good.
Yeah.
I do think this is a really interesting map, but in the last few minutes, but I think at the start it's quite slow. It gets a bit campy. It's only when there's like a pull that it gets really interesting.
Yeah, agreed. Rick's actually pulling. King of TP is going to get the return though. Avatis is going to try, but
Kusu misses shot on Chop Killers.
Yeah. Chop Killers even has his overdrive, so there's no way anyone's pulling this. Why did Mr. Wankel drop the bomb?
There were three people next to it, but then they just drove backwards.
Yeah.
I don't think he's hit that many people with his bomb, actually. He's put some good, like, he's put some good bombs down, like, throughout the game. But I think sometimes he just wastes them.
King of TP coming in with his overdrive. This surely has to be a pull.
Nope, Avetis just managed to use his overdrive in time. Maybe Mr. Wanker can... Chopkiller misses Mr. Wanker with the overdrive.
Wow. Nice job by Team
Nice.
Finally.
Nice pull by Mr. Wanker.
That was a split of a second delay. If he was just in few inches forward, his overdrive would have reached. But Kusu with his overdrive right now, he's going to one-shot everyone. His overdrive ran. No, his overdrive also ran out at the wrong time. Wow, the flag's still there.
Oh, Rix won the overdrive fight.
Yeah.
Both him and him also had overdrive, and I think he came out on top.
At least they're in the lead, but some flips again.
Yeah, he's done that a few times now. Oh, Kusu flipped Chop Killers. Very nice shot. It's interesting to see Kusu change to Railgun, actually. I would have thought he... Because he's been missing quite a lot. I would have thought he would have sticked to Magnum, but... Kusu's got an overdrive, actually, at the moment.
I think
maybe he can pull. And... Oh, Marek hits him with the first free shot. Wow. That was unfortunate.
Why didn't he use his overdrive and take
Marek? I don't know. I would have camped at the house, used my overdrive, killed Marek, and then started killing everyone else. I'm not quite sure why he didn't use his overdrive. Maybe. But if you can one-shot someone and you're in a good place to do it, then you might as well. TP's pulling now, got his overdrive, but Sandgun's there. He won't be able to do much.
Oh, someone used...
Oh, Chop Killers again doesn't have his overdrive reach far enough, but nice shot by Marek.
Yarek's gonna cap this though.
Yeah.
Team Pointer's finally looking in control. I think they're probably gonna be able to win this round from here, hopefully. And then we'll see what happens in the next round.
Yeah, I knew they would do well this side, because they play this map all the time.
They know how to play Bobrovsk.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Rix is actually... Ooh, nice shot by Kusu. He almost got out with that.
Under 4 minutes left, so... They just need to hold on to the lead here, and then they'll be through. They'll be winning this round at least. And
yep.
At least start their comeback. I don't know if they'll complete it, but we'll see. That'll be their first round win if they manage to win this round.
If they just take each round as it comes, they'll be fine.
Yeah. I don't think they should think about it too much from here. Just try to win every single round and play positively, attacking game. But imagine if they're able to pull off this comeback, that's going to be probably one of the biggest grand finals comeback.
Yeah, definitely.
Even though we've seen a lot of them. CC, the last CC we saw, the grand final going to Ben. Was it CC? I forgot, but like one tournament grand final went to playoff penalties. I'm pretty sure it was the
grand final. I think so.
I set up
some. Was it set? No, not setups.
No, not the grand finals, but the setups, losers bracket.
Well, Avetis is pulling. Oh, but he hits the wall and damages himself. Maybe Semgun can still pull. Rick has his overdrive. Nice overdrive by Chop Killers. Mr. Anker's there. Semgun's escaping with the flag. He's no double armor. Nice shot by Kusu with his overdrive. Rick needs to hurry up. Immortals spawned there. Avetis grabs the flag. It just gets that. All they need is one more to tie and they've won.
Yeah, Eternity just need one capture right here.
Oh, I think Kusu can get out with this. Maybe Rick should have used his overdrive. I don't know if Kusu's going to die now. He's 1 HP. Yarek's flipped himself. Or not. I think there's a very big chance here for Eternity. Rix and Avetis both in the base. With the... Oh, Avetis flips! Rix can.
And Chop Killers return. So Rix, can he get out?
Rix! Can he get out from that Firebird? He's got no one to help him. Immortal with the return.
Semgun can pull again though.
Oh, Semgun, can he use his bomb? Oh, he's gonna flip. Oh, he hasn't flipped there again, has he? He's flipped 3 times in the same spot. One minute left. And Team Pointers hold on to this flag.
Yeah, let's see if they can.
It looks good because I think most of Eternity have used their overdrives. And Kusu's now got his, so he's just going to defend now.
Yeah, honestly, I don't think it's going to happen.
King of TP has an overdrive as well, he's probably going to use anyway. Immortals on his overdrive as well. 20 seconds, I don't think that's enough time for capture. Which means Team Pointers are still in it.
Yeah, so we're gonna move to round number 8. And the score would be 4-1. They would the team pointers would need 3 more wins to continue to the penalties. But
I'd love to see a penalty, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Okay. We're going to pick winners first, and then we'll pick open the form again. Orally. But are you sure? I thought we did, but I mean, maybe you're right. So we're gonna open the form now, because we didn't after last time. So the form's open, guys. Go ahead and enter your nicknames.
So team pointers now on the bad side. I wonder how they'll do now. I think Eternity's defense is going to be a lot stronger because Marikos can just hide behind these red houses.
Yeah.
Do you think this is going to be the last round, Duffy?
I think this is going to be a tie.
I think it's going to be a tie.
That's my prediction. But maybe Eternity might win. But honestly, I think it's going to be a tie. And then we're going to end the stream right here. Unless we see something magical from Team Pointers that nobody expects them to do. It's going to be close, is my opinion. There's going to be a one flag difference, but I honestly think it's going to be a tie. Same teams, I guess, for both, yeah.
Bit of an early sell from Avetis. I was a bit naughty, but we move.
There's literally 15 admins, I mean 15 specs watching. Nobody said anything, so I guess it.
Nice overdrive by King of TP.
He's probably using it because Yarik has his.
Yeah. Looks like a big push from Team Pointers coming on.
Actually, that's smart.
Who can pull this?
Yeah, this is.
Unless a Vetus does something crazy with Magnum. Oh, Vetus is overdrive. Well played by Rix.
Oh my god.
Wow, Rix. Rix has had his Weetabix.
At least he stops everyone.
Oh, Vix is actually pulling, but he's been frozen. And Mr. Anchor spawns on top of him. He just got one shot. That was unfortunate.
Vix does flip, but Tropkillers is going to continue this pull. Most likely, Kusu is not going to be able to stop him. Eternity with the lead.
Yeah, Vank didn't spam DA when he spawned. Because when you spawn, you have to like spam DA as fast as you can, so you don't take any damage before you've activated your DA. But he waited like a second before he pressed it.
Yeah, honestly, like he just one-shots Vank as soon as he spawns.
Maybe Kusu can pull this, actually. Oh, he missed his shot. I'm like...
Oh, Vanker going the right way. He's going to avoid a lot of people.
No, Tropkillers is there with his... What? Maybe he can. Avetis. Avetis the flag. Avetis.
Wow. Okay, Avetis. Tropkillers? Oh my god, dude.
Oh no.
No way. Yeah, he should have just gone for the gap. But King of TP pulling again. He's got overdrive this time. Whoa.
No, he just got ended. Marikos is pulling again now. Marik takes the flag. Can Mr. Anker pull without flipping? He mustn't flip. He jumps without flipping. Oh, he's a god. Look at him. He's got a health kit as well. Marek's in a bit of trouble with Immortal there. Oh, King of TP should be able to return this. And he does. 1-1.
They could have at least, it could have been 4-1 for Team Pointers, to be honest. But I have to settle with the one. But actually, King of TP, this is looking really good. But he flips. But still, Yarik has managed to pull this. Kusu has overdrive. This should be a capture.
Yeah, it should be. 2-1 to Team Pointers.
Okay, they've done it so far where they've managed to take the lead in the blue base. We just need to hold on to this lead.
Yep. I mean, I still think there's flags to be captured in the next 6 minutes. For sure. But nice overdrive, King of TP, but Chop Killers is there anyway and gets the return.
Yeah, it was a nice try from him, but...
Oh, nice double by Kusu. Do you see that? All the way through the base.
Oh, Kusu has a good chance right here. Everyone's on respawn.
Mike actually left and rejoined. Oh, he's run out of his overdrive now, but... Nice overdrive by Chop Killers. And Chop Killers is doing so well with Hunter. And so is King of TP, actually. Both of them are really using their overdrives well. Can Riggs pull this?
Wow.
Has he had enough Weetabix? Is he going to get spawn killed again? Oh, no, Vetus. There's a bomb.
Oh, he just runs into the bomb.
I did not hear it. Well, Chop Killers could pull, actually. King of TP's there. Can he do anything? Nice pull by Chop Killers. Wow.
Immortal's going to pull 100%, though.
Great, great play by Riggs. Riggs needs to grab the flag, though. I don't think Immortal will go anywhere because Chop Killers has just spawned and he's got Marek there as well.
But Riggs is in
trouble. How is Riggs getting away with this?
Yeah, he's surrounded by three people.
I think Team Points can pull this. If King of TP uses an overdrive, he does. It's going to be a capture.
Don't flip. Okay.
Don't flip.
Wow, you're right. This is really dominating now. Bobrus is their map, I guess. 3-1 for Team Pointers.
Yep. Sim Guns, can he pull this flag now? Chop Killers are going to block Mr. Anker and King of TP. I think they could even pull another one, actually. Simgan's definitely going to capture this. Whether Chop Killers can pull again is another question.
Yeah, true.
I think at the moment, Team Pointers are getting their overdrive just before Eternity, and then Eternity are getting theirs, which is why you saw Team P pull, and then Eternity pull straight after.
Chop Killers is not going to be able to pull this.
Oh, if Simgan puts a bomb, he could pull this.
Wow.
Wow. Another. Ooh, I thought he was going to flip. Yeah. I thought he was going to flip. Wow. Another capture for Eternity.
Wow.
Three and a half minutes.
Eternity, I thought they were out of this game, but they just captured two flags in like a minute or so.
Marek's in a bit of trouble now. Does a Vetus have overdrive? I don't think so. Kusu does.
Mr. Wanka.
Nice play by Chop Killers. Oh, but Riggs has his Thunder Overdrive.
Oh my gosh.
Nice, Riggs. Mr. Weetabix.
This is really good. King of TP with his overdrive now, and he's gonna... Oh my god.
This one shot. What a shot with Magnum. He can pull, actually. But King of TP is there. Can he one-shot him? Oh, he missed!
Wow.
It's so hard to hit with Magnum close range now.
Sam Grand is gonna put a bomb. He's gonna take every. Oh, he puts he his bomb doesn't disable my anyway. Ah, this is so close. 2.5 minutes left. And this is a do or die time for Team Pointers.
Do or die. Okay. Yeah. One of our event helpers, I believe. Is he an event helper? I don't know.
But
he's a contest organizer, yeah. I knew he had Neon.
Two minutes in. I don't know. There's only. Actually, there's three players from Eternity with overdrives now. Mr. Vanka, King of KP, Immortal, all have
overdrives. And Yarrick. And Yarrick.
Wow.
This looks promising for them. They need to capture now to stay in the game. Can King of TP do it? I think he's going to die.
Rix used his overdrive.
Oh, it was just too late. Oh, and Chop Killers. With his Hunter overdrive. And I think Eternity will be getting their overdrives very soon now.
Yarrix got his overdrive.
Miraculous has his as well.
Kusu has his. Once. Kusu has his overdrive and King of TP. This has to be the chance.
Wait, Chop Killers is pulling.
No,
I don't think he's going to go anywhere.
Kusu with his overdrive.
No. Oh, Kusu takes out Avedis. If Marek kills Kusu, it's basically game over.
Oh my god.
Sam Grand killed King of TP.
Mr. Venka, can he pull?
He's being blocked by Marikos.
He's so low on
HP. He's going to get taken out.
Rix
he's 1 HP. Rix gets the return.
This is not looking good. 40 seconds. Kusu's the only hope.
Look at them all pushing from the middle. This is for acid, boys.
Let's go, champ. 30 seconds.
Let's go, champ.
I don't know, Rix. He's not. No.
King of TP's got his overdrive.
Oh, he's
it. Wow, but he's burning. He's 1 HP. He can get taken out. Nice double by Avetis.
Immortal.
With his overdrive, he's just going to camp there. Avetis has got it.
Yeah,
Avetis saved the day for eternity.
You're right.
Oh. 10 seconds? No way. No way. No way.
He's getting
no
dropped.
Way. Game over. Oh. What a close game.
8 rounds. I correctly predicted. I just didn't predict the right winner. So, to Eternity for winning Acid and winning the whole tournament. So very well played. The grand final especially. A lot of people didn't expect them to do this well, but they've done it. So congratulations.
Indeed. Do we need to announce any winners or are we done here? Okay, we need to announce winners.
We'll quickly pick the last set of winners. And they're on your screens now. The three winners are. God, it's taking so long. Exorthus, Murder, Hornet, and San Marino. Congrats, guys. Okay, Greg, you can get that one.
Right. Okay, well, thank you very much, guys, for being with us for these just over 2 hours. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you very much to Loyalty, our broadcaster for today, and to Defeat for commentating with me, and Mr. Legend in the background, and obviously to you guys for joining us the stream. That's it for Tough Dream Team, obviously. That was the grand final. So coming up, we've got Masters of the Swords Trio, which will start streaming soon, I presume. So yeah, stay tuned, guys, and see you in the next stream.
Yep, thanks, guys, for coming in. And we'll see you next time.
superhero.